Hello there, and as usual, I'm Aaron from Last Stand Gamers, and welcome. So today we've got a special guest.
Hello, my name is Marek Rosa, and I'm the founder of Keen Software House.
So we've got him here, we've got some awesome questions to ask him, both from you and from the audience in general. So we're going to start with, what made you come up with the idea for Space Engineers? What were you doing at the time?
Space Engineers started as a successor to Minor Wars, our previous game. And in this game, we wanted to focus more on constructive aspects of the game. So players will build real constructions, and which will behave according to physical laws and simulation. And I remembered my older ideas that I had 10 years ago, inspired by LEGO Technic. Back then, I wanted to create a game that where players will build cities and cars from little blocks that will snap together. And the idea was that it will be interactive world without static environment. And so these ideas, these old ideas came back to me when we started on Space Engineers, and we are going that direction.
Oh, very nice. So what made you go with space then, if the original idea was elsewhere?
Yeah, maybe because of our older game or previous game, Minor Wars, we kind of like get stuck in the space. But it also has some advantages, like in space you can have jetpack, and you can have gravity generators, you can have ships that can fly and move, whereas if it would be on the ground, the game would be different. And but this doesn't mean that we will not move to ground at some point in future.
All right, very nice. So the next point I'm going to move on to is survival, or a survival sort of game mode. Can you discuss like a little bit about the game modes that we're going to be seeing, and maybe a little bit what they're about?
Mm-hmm. So survival, we actually call it manual mode, and the difference between manual and creative mode is that in manual mode you can actually die, and you can respawn, you can heal. When you want to build something, you need to harvest or refine it in refinery, then you know, go to assembler and stuff like that. So it's more realistic, and this is the mode that the game will run in. And then there are scenarios, and there can be scenario, for example, like survival. So you start at abandoned asteroid and you really need to survive, and or you will start at some really big station with everything at your hand. And and right now we are actually finishing this manual, or as you call it, survival mode. And because we think that a multiplayer will need this mode a lot, you know, without finished survival manual mode, the game will not have its how to say this, you know, there will not be competition. So that's it.
Right. So, talking a bit about multiplayer, what can we expect to see in multiplayer? Are we going to be seeing big things, or is it going to be limitations, or what's it going to be about?
I don't think there will be any limitations, any new limitations. And basically, until now, we still try to make the game without limitations if we don't have to, such as you can have spaceship of any size, and we didn't put a limit to this. So it's quite possible that we will not put a limit on number of players in a server, that we'll just leave it to people to decide what's best for their for the performance of their computers and bandwidth of their internet connection. And in my opinion, basically multiplayer is just what you already have now, and just like allow people to connect together. That, you know, that's the only thing that's multiplayer in the game.
Oh, very nice. So what would you like to see in multiplayer? Would you like to see everyone working together? Is that the main idea? Is like get everyone constructing things together and building big projects?
Yeah, that would be nice. But actually, I think that what we will see is that people will engage in wars against each other. But we hope that this will not be the usual first-person shooter kind of experience. And we hope that people will actually focus more on the construction and strategic part of the war, and so they will build strong stations or motherships, and so that they will not engage in man-to-man combat, but they will actually operate these big machineries and use them as their weapons. That's what we would like to see, and I think many people will just do cooperative building, and that's great as well.
Well, that sounds great. I can imagine lots of people working together to build some massive weapons of mass destruction. Right, so you talked about asteroids before being in the environment and players being stuck on them. And what can we expect to see in the environment? Are we going to see just more asteroids? Or are we going to see sort of different sectors or maybe even planets?
We were all already discussing the idea of having planets in our team. It's just not an actual topic that we are working on. The thing is that what people need to realize is that a planet will consume a lot more memory than an asteroid. Even if we do a lot of optimizations, the thing is that the environment is deformable, and all these changes need to be stored in memory somehow. So right now, what I think in the short term that we will do is we will change the world generator, so it will generate a little bit more realistic asteroids with better distribution of ore. So for example, you don't have a piece of gold on the surface of an asteroid. It should be hidden somewhere in the middle. And or in the center, and maybe we'll add a little more asteroids, because the number of asteroids that's currently in the game is still from the few months old idea, or you know, like the vision that we actually had only 32-bit version of the game with limited memory. Now we have this 64-bit, and so memory is not such a big issue as it used to be a few months ago. So I think we can make more asteroids, and when we'll but the second part of my answer is that once we finish multiplayer and the survival and things like that, we expect people to come up with new ideas or like new suggestions. And if you will see that the one of the biggest direction they want us to go is bigger sectors or planets or bigger environment, then we'll most probably go that way. So we'll just, right now, we're just waiting what will happen in next few months.
Right, that sounds great. I'm sure people are very excited to hear that sort of stuff. But moving on, let's talk about a few little mini topics. So one of the things is armor. Obviously, you've probably heard a lot about different thicknesses, different layers. And then we've also got about different weapon types, and then maybe a little bit about customization. So like customizing your character, maybe putting a flag on his shoulder or something. So what have you got about what's going on about them? Have you thought of anything about them, or is that nothing on your list yet?
So regarding armor, right now the game has light armor. Some people know how to enable heavy armor, and really soon we should make heavy armor more official, so it will be like in the game from the start, and it should be it should have better protection, like a few times better resistance than light armor. It should be heavier with bigger weight, and it should be also harder to construct. You just need to more metal to build heavy armor, but it should sustain more damage from missiles. And this is actually the moment where we want to balance the strength of missile explosion, because right now people say that they are overpowered, which I kind of agree, and but we'll see how this will appear once we add heavy armor. So maybe it will be just right, maybe not. And but by the way, here it's really good to have this kind of feedback from the community, because we all, I'm just right now I'm just a little bit going away from your question. I'm just saying about this feedback thing that after the last update, we get a lot of comments that the missiles are overpowered. So, you know, this this kind of feedback will get on top of all feedback that we have, and so it became an important thing. So we realized, like, okay, so we need to focus on missiles and how balanced they are, and that leads us to another thing. And so we actually expect to get something like that after we add heavy armor, so people will have more information to consider, and we'll get some more feedback. So back to your original question, regarding customization, we don't have any actual plans on character customization, like flags or colors or stuff like that. We have the vision of this game that it should be about things you build and then what you do with these things you build, and it should be less about your character or your body. And I'm not saying that we will never do this character customization, maybe after a few months or a year or something like that. If people will strongly like want us to do it, then we'll most probably do it. But right now we think that there are maybe more important things or more unique things that we can focus on, like all these new types of blocks that we would like to create. So I think I answered your question.
Yeah, you answered it very well, and you gave us a lot of information, and I'm sure people are very happy, and it's great that people are also giving you a lot of feedback on such information as well, because I'm sure it's really going to help you on your development of the game. Talking about the development of the game, what's the largest hurdle that you're kind of running into at the moment? What's the biggest problem or the thing that you're working on to try to get over?
Well, the biggest feature we are working on right now is multiplayer, but I wouldn't call it a problem or a hurdle. The funny thing about space engineers, and this may sound like bragging, but I just feel it. It's like we didn't have any problem during the whole development period, and it was so flawless, you know, like everything just worked the way it should work. And my teammates, they created what they wanted to create in reasonable timetables and milestones and all those things. So it's really, I mean, it's everything in space engineers looks too good to be true, to be honest. So we don't have any problems. We are just doing our thing and finishing one feature after another feature, and it's just working.
Well, it sounds absolutely great, and I, from my personal opinion, think you're doing a great job, and I'm sure there's a lot of people out there as well that are doing a great job, so I want to thank you for that. And I just really want to thank you for also answering the questions today. It's going to probably excite a lot of people. A lot of people are going to be like, oh God, there's all these exciting things to come. I can't wait. But yeah, thanks for coming today, and hopefully everyone else enjoyed it.
Thank you, and goodbye.